Hi, everyone. This is Tracia Bolin with Worthy, a fashion meetup. And I am thrilled today to have Joanie Helgesen here with us. And she's going to tell us a little bit about her story. Joanie is, let me tell you, this lady is very impressive here that we have with us. And I want to tell you a little bit about her before we get started. She is a Miss Senior Florida America 2007. She's in the top 10 nationally for that. And then she's Mrs. Senior Founding Queen USA 2016. And she's in the Hall of Fame. She is also a Miss Senior Florida USA 2016, Miss Super Senior Florida 2017, Images of Gem International Golden Miss 2018, and a Mrs. Super Senior Florida 2018, Mrs. Super Senior USA 2013 and 2020, and also Mrs. Super Senior Norway Universe 2019, Super Senior Universe 2020, Joanie Helgesen. Hi, how are you, Joanie?
I'm great, thank you.
Well, I'm glad you got to come on here today, and I'm really excited to hear some of your story. I saw some of your bio, and you just have an incredible, like, a life story, some things you've been through, and wow, what an accomplishment of all your pageants and all the places and things you've seen. Wow.
Thank you.
Joanie's excellent adventures that you said, right?
That's right. Exactly. Shall I start from the beginning?
Go ahead. Share us a little bit about who's Joanie and tell us about some of your story.
Okay. Well, I am 81 years old. I am adopted. I was put into an orphanage right at birth, right out of the hospital. I found my birth family in my late 40s, and I've heard all about how I was given to the orphanage immediately. My birth mother was never allowed to look at me or hold me. And my birth family was there at the hospital, and they all cried watching the Lutheran nuns take me away. And I consider myself very fortunate because I was adopted, and my adoptive family was told that my birth family was musically inclined. And so my adoptive family pursued that for me. I had piano lessons when I was 8, and I started harp lessons when I was 9, and I started playing professionally on the harp when I was 10. Wow. And the funny thing is that it turned out my birth family, my birth parents were not musically inclined, but my birth grandparents sang. So my adoptive parents took a chance, but it turned out that I am musically inclined.
Wow, that is fantastic. That is so interesting.
Yeah.
So they kind of helped, nurture your talents and your gifts in that area then. You said you play the harp?
I am a harpist. I've been playing professionally since I was 10. And
incredible.
Performing on the harp is my talent in the pageants. Oh. I really didn't start being serious about pageants until about 4 years ago. I was a tap dancer and showgirl and harpist with the Florida Follies here. I started tap dancing lessons when I was 58, and I lived in Palm Springs, California, and I appeared in shows there also. I moved to Florida about 18 years ago. I can't believe it's been that long. And I auditioned for the Florida Follies. And so I've been playing the harp and dancing. And I retired from the Follies about 4 years ago. And then I was asked to do pageants. And I thought, oh, I'm not good enough to do that. I can't do that. And lo and behold, I have won several titles. I'm very grateful. I mean, who knew? Here I am, 81. And I've won these titles.
Fantastic. That is amazing. It's wonderful. What a story with all that coming through that. How did you get introduced to pageants? I mean, how did you even get interested in it?
Well, I was asked to be in a pageant. My first pageant was Miss Senior America 2007. And then I didn't do anything again until about 4 years ago.
Wow, that is incredible. And you've won, so how many titles you won now? At least?
I'm not sure. I have an area where I have my crowns and my trophies and my banners and photos. And there, I must say, there are quite a few.
I bet you've been able to touch a lot of people's life with your music and being, you know, having a title, being able to impact a lot of people. What was your, did you have to have a platform for those when you had those titles?
In my case, there was a category of people that came from an orphanage or the foster system, and I would share my talent. And I do believe it's a God-given talent. For years, when I don't play, I can still pick it up and perform. And I just think it's a God-given talent to show other people.
Yes.
I think people in assisted living facilities and nursing homes, I think they love the music. And there are cases of some people who have dementia who can still remember music from way back.
Yes. That is a great gift to give to others. And are you still doing that? Are you still going around and helping people with that, with your music?
Well, at the moment, since I won my last title on 2020, I'm going back to Las Vegas again in March, I think it is, there's Miss Super Senior Universe in March, but then in May, I'm going to Seattle, Washington, as I have been nominated for an award there, the Global Beauty Awards.
Wow.
And we are voted on all around the world. So if you win that honor, you know that people from around the world have voted for you. So I'll be going to Seattle, I think it's May, in May.
That's wonderful. That just to hear some of your story and all the things you've been through, and how you give credit to God for your gifts. That is amazing.
In fact, I thank God every day when I get out of bed.
We all do, that's for sure. I tell you what, we need him, don't we?
Yes, we do. I have another cause, and it's animals. Oh. I rescue animals. It just hurts me so much when I see animals that have been neglected and abandoned. And yes, here in Florida, there are people that abandon their dogs or cats in the Everglades and just leave them with the alligators and the anaconda and the pythons.
Oh, my goodness.
Thank heavens there is a group that goes to the Everglades to save the animals that have been abandoned.
Are you a part of that group that does that?
No, I haven't been able to have time for that, but I think I'm going to inquire, because yeah, I think it's such a wonderful cause. Otherwise, those animals would have been doomed. I mean, there's no doubt about it.
Yeah, definitely. That is a good cause. I really do like that. It says you had a steer, a white,
yes,
Sicilian burro.
I did. When I lived in Wisconsin, I'm from Wisconsin originally. And in my last marriage, my house was on 350 acres in Wisconsin. Oh. And so I had pets. And yes, I had a pet steer. His name was Tuffy. Mm. And a white Sicilian burro, a pony, 8 llamas, 2 sheep, 2 goats, and 4 exotic chickens.
Wow, that's incredible. So you have a passionate heart for animals, and you've had a farm, pretty much. Yeah.
Well, and at that time I was a harpist in a symphony, but I also had my animals.
right. It sounds exactly like you had that. And you had a feeding program for the swans too, right?
Yes, when I lived in Palm Springs, California, I lived in a community that was on acreage of water. Of course, it was man-made. It was in the desert. And when I moved there, there were 12 swans wandering the streets, starving. That community had no feeding program for them. The developers just sort of place swans on the water just so it looks pretty, but there's no feeding program. So I was an advocate for a feeding program for the swans for the communities there.
Yeah.
And I, having had animals, I knew a little bit about what swans would eat. And so I established the feeding program there. And I also designed and built feeders for them that I would place along the shoreline. But the funny part is I would have to chase down the swan and put his head in the feeder because otherwise they didn't know what to do. So therefore that swan would teach the other swans how to eat out of the feeder. And wow. I was also known to have swans in the back of my station wagon as I drove around the community.
Oh my goodness. That is amazing. So what are you involved with, any kind of programs or outreaches that people can kind of get in touch with you, or they can kind of they can kind of connect with you with your
absolutely, if they would like to connect with me. I'm not involved in a program at the moment, but after I go to Seattle in May, you know, possibly I will be, but sure, anybody can contact me. Absolutely.
Okay. And how would they do that? Can you tell them how to get a hold of Joanie Helgesen?
It's Helgesen. It's like Helga had a son, but it's all E's. Helgesen.
And where's that come from? What is that origin from? Let's see. Helgesen.
That's Norwegian.
Norwegian. I thought that was okay.
And I was actually raised Norwegian by my adoptive family, and like Lutefisk and Lefse and Rumagrut. And so I've always considered myself Norwegian. Recently, I went to a 23andMe to find out really who I was with my DNA. And it turned out I'm English, German, and Irish. But I still think I'm Norwegian.
Well, it sounds like your name is a very strong, it sounds like it could be a Norwegian descent for sure.
Yes.
Well, congratulations on all your titles and all your different things that you've done. What a great adventure. And I love hearing your story of, wow, that is so amazing what God has brought you through from your, you know, just being adopted and raising up through your family. It sounds like you've, you know, just overcome so much through all that. Do you have any words of encouragement? I know with Runway to Life, we like to give words of encouragement to people who have a hard time sometimes overcoming or sometimes lose hope. Do you have any words that somebody who might be losing hope that they can overcome?
I would like to add that I'm also a survivor of abuse. And there's always a light at the end of the tunnel, even though you don't think there is. You've lost hope. Your self-esteem is so low. Somehow, God helps you. I was in a situation for quite a few years that I really couldn't get out of. I couldn't find a way to get out. And finally, I did. And I just think it was with the help of God that I was able to do that. And it takes a while to recover from that, but I have. And I just want people to know that there's always hope. Just pray. Yes. I prayed a lot.
Yes.
And I believe there is always hope. Amen. Never give up hope. Do not give up hope. And for some reason, that comes to my mind about bullying, which I think is so horrendous. I don't want the kids that are being bullied to ever give up hope, because they are better than the bullies. They have more to offer than the bullies. And the bullies are probably jealous of them because they are special. So I just don't want them to ever give up hope. I've heard too many stories about suicides because of bullying.
Yeah.
And I don't want that to ever happen to anybody.
Yes.
Also, you mentioned, how could someone get a hold of me?
Yes.
Would you like my email address?
Yes, if you would like to share that, we can share that live on here, your email or whatever you feel free that you would like to share. If people wanted to contact you, you could share that on here.
All right. How about my email address?
Okay.
Which is the harp lady at AOL.
The harp lady at AOL. All right.
Yes.
Thank you. And thank you for taking some time today to share some of your story. And is there anything else that you wanted to share with us that you didn't get to about Joanie that we don't know?
That you don't know.
Well, anything else you want to say while we're on here before we go?
Yeah, I must say that I think life begins at 60. That's when I decided to take my excellent adventures. So no matter what I do or where I go, it's another excellent adventure. And I just, at 81, I'm grateful every single day, but I still have more excellent adventures in me.
That's right. We're thankful for every day, right?
That's right.
We count our blessings. We don't know how many days we have, and we're thankful for each day we're given. Amen. That's good.
That's right.
Good stuff, Joanie. And I'm so glad to meet you. And I'm thank you for your time today and sharing some of your story. And again, congratulations on all the great things that you've done and accomplished and all the things you've overcome in your life. And that's just incredible.
Thank you very much. I'm so happy to meet you.
I'm so happy to meet you too. You take care. Thanks again.
Thank you. Okay. Bye.